Now let us get started with the new format, right? So Python, episode 26.md, right? So new style for formatting strings, right? So the old style was to use percentage d, percentage yes, which was much mostly inherited from C. So the new format, okay, of Python is, right, let me use new style of formatting strings. Formatting strings has the following format, right? That form is simply you have to tell, okay, what is your format string dot format, okay, and then here you pass data. So let me try to give a very simple example. Let me go inside the Python interactive shell, right, or interactive Python or REPL, whatever you call it, okay. I'm trying to write name equals to, okay, let me write name equals to Python, okay, category equals to automation or programming, right? Now if I want to print a string, I'll be writing something like hello, right? And then I will try to tell that welcome to curly braces, okay, category is again one more curly braces, and now I will be writing dot format of name comma category. Are you seeing this? Right here you need not worry about it, right? So if we want, we can basically do this. Name equals to, right, okay, websites equals to 3, okay. Now I'm trying to tell hello, this is, and I have websites, right, dot format of, I'll be passing name comma websites. Am I clear on this? Right. So whatever order of curly braces which you have, you can basically try to use it. But what will you do if you have to use name twice, right, or some stuff twice, right? So let me try to tell place equals to Hyderabad, country equals to India, right? So I'm writing is great country, okay, and is in, okay, and then I have to write format, and then here first for pass the country and then the place and then the country again. So rather than doing this, what Python tries to tell is, don't do this, give numbering. So it starts with 0 is your first argument, okay, this 1 is your second argument, and here you pass 0 again. Now in this case there is no need for you to pass the same argument multiple times, you can achieve this. Are we clear on this, sir? Yeah. So you can give this kind of numberings. This works in Python 2 as well as Python 3 also, right? Python 2.6 onwards, this kind of syntax works, right? Fine. Let me take a screenshot of this. Okay. And let me save this. Right. Right. So I'll save this image so that you can basically look into stuff. Python 56.png. It is 56 or 57. 57. Right. Good. Right. So, sir, if basically, whenever you want to use the stuff, right? Okay, we can use whenever you are trying to work with the stuff. If you don't want to give zeros and ones, there is one more way. So what is that one more way, right? So that one more way is, I don't fit everything over here, so I can write country, okay, is great country, and then place, right, is in country. Am I clear on this? And then you can write dot format, okay, country equals to India and place equals to Bangalore, or let me stick to Hyderabad because all the examples will be sounding the same. Okay, so if you don't like numberings, you can do this. Am I clear on this, sir? So you can go with zeros, or you can give names to that stuff. The choice is yours, right? Or why to have different images? Let me have this image for everything. Okay, right. So this is basically the way of formatting the stuff. But I'll be using the newest style in the classroom, so that is personally what I like, right? So if you like this format, you can, there is no one stopping you from doing this, right? But I like the newest style of Python, right? The newest style of Python, okay, right, this is the latest one. Style is something which we call as f-strings. F-strings are referred as f-strings are referred as format strings. Right, these are very simple to use, right? So before the string, you have to basically use for f keyword, right? So I might be using something like, okay, f, okay. Here, let me give a different example. Okay, so this time, let me try to speak about what should we speak about. Okay, let me speak about Android. Okay, name or OS underscore platform is Android. Okay. Company is Google. Okay. Now, if I want to print something like this, so just add a F in front of the string. You can use single or double quotes. The choice is yours. Okay. So OS underscore platform is developed by company. Okay, what is the stuff which I missed? So are you seeing this? I started with a single quote and ended with a double quote. That's a reason for failure, right? Okay. So not only this, I can use some of the string methods. OS.platform. Okay. Remember yesterday we have basically looked at string methods. Okay. String methods in Python. So I'll basically go to the standard library, right? In standard library, there are many methods. And now if you look at some of the case methods, right? So there is something called as upper, and there is something called as swap case. So what I can do is, okay, dot swap case. Okay. OS platform dot swap case. Are you seeing this? That is very simple. This is the most easiest one, right? So I use this a lot, right? So if you think that you want to use it in a different fashion, you can basically use that, right? Okay. Now let me try to show you this example. Okay. So I'll go with my first example, and then I will try to tell, okay, I'm using a colon, okay, and then I would try to tell that greater than 10, okay, and then over here I would try to tell that colon dot. You will not use all of this, but let me try to see what happens. Oh, what else did I miss? Oh, right. Colon. Okay. Dot. Greater than 20. Now, are you seeing? It has given, okay, some of this stuff over here. So, what does it mean? What does it mean? Okay, so the thing which it is trying to tell us, okay, let me try to run the whole stuff commands again, because it would be easy for me to take the screenshots. The second one is swap case, the third one is this, and now let me try to tell you this. Okay, I'll be trying to write OS platform equals to, okay, and then company equals to. Sorry, saying so over here, this expression means give me 10 spaces before you write this expression. This expression means surround with 20 dots, 10 in the front and 10 basically after the stuff. So you have a lot of these kind of expressions. Okay. So this is fun, and anyway you can find them. Generally you might not be using them, but this is something which you use very often. You try to tell what is the name of your value, and then you try to print it, right? So if you want to do that, this is the most easiest way to do it. And you would see me using only F strings in the classroom a lot, because I personally find this easier and interesting. Okay. So now it is your choice. You have three ways of formatting or interpolating the strings. You can prefer whatever approach is sensible for you. Whatever approach is sensible for you. Right, sir? Good. Now what we would try to do is, okay, we know about the strings now, okay? But in Python, right, apart from the basic data types, there are some of the data structures. There are some of the data structures which are little bit complex, right? So that complexity has already started with string, where we have tried to tell that string is sequence of characters. Okay. So Python has other two sequence types, right? So let me write it like Python has two other sequence types in addition to strings. Right? The first one being tuples, and the second one is lists. Okay, so this might contain zero or more elements. Okay, so basically, what are these tuples and what are the lists? The basic difference is mutability. Tuples are immutable, right? You cannot change the tuples. When it comes to the strings, you can basically change the values. You can change the values, right? So let me get started or introduce to you something called as tuples. Okay, right. So some people pronounce it as tuple. Some people call it as tuple, right? I'm not sure. Okay, right, fine. Now, what is basically a tuple? Okay, tuple is sequence of objects, and we know that in Python everything is an object. Okay, in Python everything is an object. Okay, so in Python, if everything is an object, in Python, if everything is an object, I can basically use this tuple to contain any kind of an object, right? So let us get started with an empty tuple. All right, so empty tuple can be defined. Okay, let me exit out of this and let me start from here. Okay, empty underscore tuple is, whenever you are seeing anything in parentheses, you will see this, and whenever you try to look what is type of empty underscore tuple. Am I clear on this? Yeah. Right, fine. Now there is one more syntax of doing, right? One underscore element underscore tuple. Let us see if this works for us. Okay, so let me call it as Python. Okay, now class of, okay, type of one underscore element underscore type. What is it? It is string. Now let me make a slight difference. Okay, after this I'll be adding a comma. Now class system. Am I clear on this? So if you don't put that comma, it will be a string, but after, right, defining that, if you put one comma, that is a one element tuple. That is a one element tuple. Am I clear on this, sir? Now if you type that one element tuple, the value of this will be, right? So tuples are basically enclosed in parentheses, right? So if you want to have more items in a tuple, right, so multiple elements tuple is equals to Python Java, right, C sharp, C, and C plus plus. And now, if I try to write type of multiple elements, and now if you try to print multiple elements tuple, you will basically do this. Now, other underscore way for multiple is equals to, you write parentheses of, okay, bash PowerShell, okay, and Python, because from Python we can do basically scripting also. Now type of other is tuple, and then when you try to write the tuple, you'll be getting it. So tuple can be defined in multiple ways. Am I clear on that, sir? So you can write with a single element, but if you forget comma over here, it will become a string. So defining tuples is very much simple. Okay, so these are all the ways of defining tuples. Okay, so focus on this. So try to look at this. This becomes string. The moment you add comma here, it becomes tuple. Okay, right? So tuples are immutable. Tuples are immutable. So what do I mean by immutable? So what is immutable, sir? We have discussed about immutability, empty tuple, single element, and multi-element example. Example, tuple declarations. Sir, what is immutable, sir? We have discussed a lot of stuff, right? Immutable means whenever you basically try to change, okay, right, generally it goes with a, it will not allow you to change, right? So since the types of Python are immutable, whenever you try to assign the value, a new memory allocation, a memory location gets created to it, gets created over here, right? So now basically, okay, what I want to do is, okay, I want to see, right, can I basically change any of the values of tuple? Okay, so before that, there is one declaration of tuple which I want to discuss. Generally we would see people doing this, right? So let me write it as, let me exit over here, okay, and let me try to write Python again. Okay, and now let me try to tell, okay, cities is equals to Hyderabad comma Bengaluru comma Chennai. Okay, yes, now if you write type of cities, it will be a tuple. Now I will try to write H comma B comma C is equals to this. Okay, now if I type H, if I type B, if I type C, I'll get this. Okay, this is basically called as tuple unpacking. This is called as tuple unpacking. Okay, so now for every element you can basically assign the value. Let us see what is type of H. String. Okay, but when you combine all of them, they will become a tuple. They will become a tuple. Am I clear on this? Right? So this feature is referred as tuple unpacking. So right, let me basically write it. Oh, right, so tuple unpacking, right? Not many of the people use this syntax. This is very rarely used, but sometimes it is very much useful kind of a feature, very much useful kind of a feature, right? So now, like any other thing, okay, so let me go to Python class tuple. Where is Python's? Okay, no, I want to go with built-in types list tuple, and let me click on class tuple. All right, so tuple class definitions, right? So whenever you are working on any class, I would recommend that please have a look at what are the different methods that are supported over here, right? So let me quickly launch PyCharm. Okay, so in PyCharm we can easily look at the built-in methods, right? So class tuple, and it is trying to tell that there is something called as iterable. Okay, we will discuss about what those things are, okay, because we have to understand the whole structure of this, right? But today we'll be playing around. Okay, right, so now creating with tuple initializer. You can create a tuple with the initializer. Okay, right. Okay, so I can basically try to tell, okay, city underscore list. Let us assume that I have a list of cities, which is called as Hyderabad, okay, Bengaluru and Chennai. So this is some list. Now I can create tuple by saying, okay, city underscore tuple is equals to tuple of city underscore list. Now if you type of city underscore tuple, you will get this. And now if you try to type for the values of city underscore tuple, you will get the values, right? So you can use this to convert the other forms into tuple. This is basically constructor. We are just creating an object. We are just creating an object, right? And to access individual elements, I can basically use city underscore tuple of 0 will give me Hyderabad, 1 will give me Bengaluru, and 2 will give me, right, Chennai. And let us see what 3 gives us. 3 gives us some error. Okay, we should know all of them, right? What are the different error cases and positive cases, right? So let me go over here and then use this. Okay, so with tuple and accessing elements using indexes, right? So this is what we have done. It is 61. Now we can combine two tuples, okay, or we can combine, why two? We can combine tuples using plus. So let me try to basically create this stuff. Okay, so let me try to have something like metro underscore cities is equals to tuple of, okay, you can use parentheses or you can go without a parentheses kind of a definition, right? So Mumbai, Chennai, right, Delhi, and right, other underscore cities is equals to Hyderabad, Pune, right, and Bengaluru, right. Now I missed something. What did I missed? Are you seeing some error over here? Oh, after Hyderabad, I have not closed the right. Fine. Okay, right. Now what I can do is, right, so let me add metro cities and then I can type, okay, metro underscore cities plus other underscore cities. Okay, so what is happening over here? Metro underscore cities, right? Sorry, saying, okay, so let me do this again, okay, because in the image I don't want errors to be shown. So metro cities, other cities, and let me write metro and other cities. So are you able to concatenate? Yeah, so combining two tuples is much like combining two strings, right? So similarly, let me do metro underscore cities star 3 or star 2. So what is happening? Remember in the string also we had the same stuff. Okay. So when we multiplied, when you use a star, basically what was happening? Duplication was happening, right? And now, right? Basically, whenever I want to compare the strings, right? So metro underscore cities, is it equals to, okay, other underscore cities, false, okay? So let me create one more stuff over here. Tuple underscore one is equals to, here I have two elements, I can hold any objects, right? So I am writing integers. Tuple underscore t two is equals to 2, 3. Tuple underscore three is equals to again 1, 2. Now let me try to see if tuple underscore one is equals to tuple underscore two. No. Is it equals to tuple underscore three? Am I clear on this, sir? Yeah. So you can basically do some kind of arithmetic, okay, with respect to the stuff. These are combining tuples with plus, duplicating tuples with star, and comparing tuples with double equals to, right? So okay, fine, all right. Or let me do this, let me start from here. Good, let me save this image. 60. All right. Fine, sir. So let us proceed further. Okay. So what is tuple now? Tuple is basically sequence of objects, right? Sequence of objects which cannot be changed, which cannot be changed, right? So change part I have not spoken about it, but let me quickly iterate through a tuple. Okay, so sequences, and then let me try to create a new Python file, okay, which is tuple demo, okay, right? Now let me try to write words equals to, right, running, okay, out of ids. I've written something which looks like this. Okay, now if I want to write a very simple function, a very simple for loop, so I'll be writing for word in words, okay, print word. Okay, am I clear on this? So define tuple underscore simple underscore loop. Am I clear on this, sir? Okay. So since this is a function, let me basically take this. Okay. And whenever I am writing this function, okay, so this function demonstrates the simple tuple iterations, right? So it will not return anything as such, right? And let me also format the file. Yes, sir. Okay. Now if I want to call this function from main.py, so what is that I'll be doing? Okay, import sequences dot tuple demo. Now tuple dot, okay, or what was our method's name? Okay, tuple underscore simple underscore loop. Tuple underscore simple underscore loop. Now, how can I basically access this? Okay, sequences dot tuple demo dot tuple underscore simple underscore loop. Am I clear on this? So this is the calling code. Okay, but this is what you can run. Now, if you want to run this function, you can say run. Okay, if you want, you can put a breakpoint and then run debug main. Okay, I want to get inside the function, so step into, right? So words, now in the first loop the word becomes running and the second word becomes out of ideas. Now if you basically look into debug console, is did it printed everything? Yes sir. So I'm writing very simple class over here. Okay, so iterating tuples. So I have written function because it looks clean. There is no other reason for that. There is no other reason for that. Okay. All right. Now, let me try to modify the loop. Let me try to modify the tuple. Okay. So modify the tuple. I'm not writing a function. The reason for that is when you execute the function, you will see the error. But right here, if I can directly see the error. So if you print what is tuple underscore 1, tuple underscore 2, and tuple underscore 3. Now, if I say tuple underscore 1, okay, plus tuple underscore 2, you get this. But if I try to tell tuple underscore 1 is equals to tuple underscore 1 plus tuple underscore 2, right? Now let me try to print tuple underscore, okay, 1. I am getting this value, right? So if you want to modify a tuple, you can do this, right? But let me try to do this, okay? So tuple underscore 1 of 0 equals to 5. Am I clear on this? So there are some of the operations you cannot change the elements, you cannot change the individual elements of the tuple, okay, because it doesn't support item assignments. But if you want to modify, you can modify the whole tuple. But here, okay, this comes from the same principle. Now let us go with lists, right? The difference between tuple and lists is, in tuples, individual items cannot be modified. But when it comes to lists, individual items can be modified. Okay. Sequence of objects which are mutable. Okay. Right. So you can change the list. You can add new elements. You can do the stuff. So creating with square bracket. Right. So in Python, you don't have those static arrays. We have dynamic stuff, lists. Right. So you can try to tell something like, okay, languages is equals to Python, C sharp, JavaScript, okay, Java, and C. Okay, now if you type, what is the type of languages? It is a list. Okay, now what is basically languages? If you try to do this, right, it is a sequence. So you can obviously use languages of 0, which will give you Python. Okay, languages of, right, so yesterday if you remember, we have used slicing operators. Yes, languages of 0 to, or let me try it, colon colon 2, right, languages of, right? So I can let me try to go with tuple. So what is the tuple which we have? Metro cities, right? Okay, other cities. Now I can type other underscore cities of colon colon 2. Sorry, saying this. So we have, did we not use this for string? Yeah. So if you want to reverse a list, if you want to reverse a list, so languages colon colon minus 1. Yeah. So all of these are available to strings, to lists, and to tuples. So we will identify why this happens in our next class anyway, right? Because I'll try to show you the whole representation of it. Now you can easily create your stuff over here, right? So let me go with this. Right. 64. Right, sir. Now you can also use list. Okay. You can also create the list. Okay. Using list. So now if I go to PyCharm and then if I try to tell list, and if I get into this, using this built-in object, so it has some methods. It has some methods. Okay. So now let me go around over here. Okay. So if you want to use this list of initializer, you can obviously do this, right? So let me try to do something. So list of Python. Right, metro underscore cities. This is a tuple, right? Now if I type list of metro underscore cities, so I can convert, okay, a string into a list by using list of, right? There is one more thing. Okay, I can try to tell, okay, a string which is like, okay, let me give, this is all right, and you are learning Python, and then I can try to tell that dot split this string. Okay, yesterday we have seen this method. Okay, with something with comma. So are you getting a list? Yes. Right, so you can use any special character to basically do this, right? You can access the elements, right? So -1, -2 and all of this stuff, right? So basically whenever you're trying to access the elements, you can use slicing. Okay, so I'm basically giving you this example, right? So the difference between list and tuple is, as of now, yes, we will be getting to know more. We'll be getting to know more, right? Yes, individual items can be changed. So let us see. I will try to tell, okay, metro underscore cities underscore list is equals to list of metro underscore cities. Now if you type metro underscore cities underscore list, so are you getting this, right? So I can basically try to modify the elements of the list, right? So how can I basically modify? I can try to tell that dot append of Bangalore, right? Now if I type metro underscore cities underscore list, so am I getting Bangalore, right? So you can use this, right? Or you can try to tell that metro underscore cities underscore list dot insert, okay, at a position 1 Hyderabad, right? And now if you type metro underscore cities underscore list, so are you able to modify the elements? Okay, right? So basically we can use the same stuff. We can combine lists using plus and duplicate lists using star. So metro underscore cities underscore list star 2, right? Am I clear on this, sir? And now you can try to tell metro underscore cities underscore list plus equals to, okay, Pune, okay, plus equals to Pune. Now let us try to see if this works out for us, okay? But a list can be added with the other list. Now let me try to use metro underscore cities underscore list. So am I able to add Pune? So am I able to change the elements, right? So if I'm able to append the elements, I'll be able to remove the elements also, right? Okay, so let me try to use del metro underscore cities underscore list of 1, right? And then let me type metro underscore cities underscore list. So are you seeing Hyderabad is gone? Am I clear on this, sir? Okay, right. So if you want to delete by values, you can say metro underscore cities underscore list dot remove Pune. Okay, so there are two kinds of stuff which you can do, right? Now you type metro cities list. Am I clear on this, sir? Yeah. So whenever you try to do, you can do insertion operators, you can do deletion, you can do all of the stuff, which is not possible in tuples, right? In tuple, you can add two tuples to create a new tuple, right? Because that is a memory location, but the values inside the tuple, you cannot change it. But when it comes to a list, you can change the values, right? So other list operations. Okay, now it would be 65 and hopefully there should be 66. Let me see if that is true or not. Yeah, good. Right, sir. Now not only that, what you can basically do is, right, okay, so you can try to tell that metro underscore cities underscore list dot pop. Okay, now it says that I have removed Bengaluru for you. Now let me run this. Am I clear on this? Okay, so if you want to delete all the items, then you can say metro underscore cities underscore list dot clear. Now if you type metro underscore cities underscore list, it will be an empty array. All right, okay. Now let me assign metro underscore list with all of these values again. Metro underscore cities underscore list equals to this again. And now if I type, okay, Mumbai in metro underscore cities underscore list, okay, so Pune in, am I clear on this? It will try to basically tell you whether you will have that or not, whether you will have or that or not, right? You can basically also count. So for example, you can try to tell that, let me try to add something like metro underscore cities underscore list plus equals to metro underscore cities underscore list. Now if I type metro underscore cities underscore list, let me see what is the value which I get. Sorry, seeing I get every city twice. Now if I try to count, okay, if I try to count how many times is Chennai present, 2. How many times is Hyderabad present? Hyderabad is not present there. Am I clear on this, sir? Yeah. So lists can be converted into a string using basically the join method, right? So now let me do one more thing. Sorted off metro underscore cities underscore list. So are you seeing they are alphabetically sorted? You can do this, or you can say metro underscore cities underscore list dot sort. Okay, so after this you type metro underscore cities underscore list, so you get this. Okay, so dot sort will basically make the sorted stuff and then try to change that in your list, right? But if you don't want to change your list, you can use sorted off. Right? So let me do this one also. Numbers equals to 2 comma 5 comma 1 comma 3. And then if I type numbers dot sort, and then if I type numbers, so is it sorting? Okay, so I can also this do this sort reverse equals to true. Now if I print numbers, I'll be getting a reverse sorted order. Okay, so length of numbers, much like how we have used the length function in string, right? So individually to change the element, numbers of, okay, 0 equals to 7, and now let me print numbers. Simple, sir. Okay, and now don't get me wrong, okay, in Python, okay, your list necessarily need not be of same type. You can have a list element where you have different types of elements, where you would have different types of elements, right? So let me save this. 67. Okay, right, so I can try to tell, okay, my sample list equals to 1 comma hello comma true comma 5.0, all right? So if you basically look at type of my sample list, it is a list, right? So my sample list of 0, if you look at what is the type of it, okay, it is int. 1 is string, 2 is boolean, 3 is float. Am I clear on this? So in one list or in one tuple, it is not necessary that you need to have the same types. You can have different kinds of types, all right? Okay, so I'll stop it at that, sir, and what I would recommend is please go through previous classes, right? So tomorrow we'll be getting into Python data model, and if you want to understand that and get deeper into Python, I would recommend that please go through previous classes, sir. All right, thank you, sir.
Thanks for watching. For more videos, subscribe our channel and click on bell icon.